What's going down, everybody? Brother Stevanius here. Welcome back to Command Centre Wargaming. So in today's video, we're going to have a look at how to do those stripes going down your model. Okay, very popular in the Horus Heresy, especially for some legions, but you could put it on any model. Now, we're going to be using an airbrush. We're also going to be using some tape to mask things off, all right? We'll be doing some masking as well. And I'm going to be giving a brief discussion on how we can use these techniques to create our own decals as well. Okay, we're also going to do a little bit of weathering with the stripes as well. Okay, take that one step further, and I'm going to go through some of my overall techniques. All right, guys, fantastic. So let's get into it. All right, everybody, fantastic. So the first thing we need to do with the model, okay, is give it a light varnish. Okay, now the why we want to do this is basically because while we're masking out the stripes, and then while we're spraying the stripes on through the stencil, no matter how careful we are, we can often get a little bit of bleed in here. Now, it's not too bad when you're using flat surfaces, all right? But when you start doing things like over here, sort of in these areas, or dare I say even over here, not that you'd even try to mask in between there, but you can, okay? It just depends how much effort you want to put in. You're always going to get some little bits of bleed going on sort of here and there, right? So it's very important, especially if you have sort of more of a novelty theme like I do. So my Alpha Legion Falchion Heavy Tank Destroyer is done by Metallic, and it's actually very, very hard to correct the finish. You can't just go through and basically get, you know, some more Tamiya, you know, clear blue or whatever it is, and then sort of go over it again. The only way you're going to get the finish exact again is basically to undercoat the whole model again and start over. Otherwise, it's going to get blotchy. Okay, you can cover it up a little bit with weathering, but I find it sort of better safe than sorry, just to, you know, take the precautions. Why would you anyway? Why would you redo the work that you've already done, right? So, so yeah, give it a bit of a light varnish. Just water the varnish down. It's really just to protect the coat so that if something does go wrong, and you'll probably see this later in the video, because chances are something will go wrong, and we do get bleed around the stripes, what it means is when we come back in there with water later, okay, we can then sort of like chip it away and then smooth it over, and it won't affect the finish of the paint. Well, it shouldn't affect the finish of the paint, depending how good your varnish is, right? So that's the first thing we need to do. All right, give it a varnish. Now, don't go too crazy on the varnish. You don't want to basically go through and chalk it on, because, you know, obviously there's a lot more work you have to do with your model, and you're going to have to go back and varnish it again anyway. Okay, so yeah, just give it a very, very light coat just to protect those layers a bit, so when you start smoothing it off or scratching it out later, there's no big drama. Okay, fantastic. So the next thing, the next piece of advice that I'd give you when doing your you're doing your masking and striping, depending on where you're at, what I would highly recommend to do is do all the washing after you do the striping, okay? Because the thing is, I'm gonna stripe this now, okay? Not only will I just have to rewash it, all right, you know, after I do the stripes, but also what it means is that I'll have to go through, I might get little parts over here that I might have to reconnect. And look, it's not a massive deal, you know, but it does save you a lot of time on your workflow as well. So it's something I like to do. All right, fantastic. Now, the next tip is when you're doing stenciling on your models, what I highly recommend for you to do is use more of a thicker paint, okay? Now, I'm not talking about thick to the point where it won't go through an airbrush. I'm just saying don't have it too thin, because the thinner it is, the more it's going to seep through the sticky tape when we put the when we spray it onto the model. Okay, we also want to make sure that we're spraying onto the model from a forward direction, and that way it doesn't spray into those sort of crevices. But it will seep through at some point. Okay, but we just have to be very careful with it. So what I'm going to do for these racing stripes, I usually use, I think it's Ufwe White or something like that, or Ufwe Grey. But what I'll do is I'll actually use this today, and I'm going to be using this Citadel paint. I'm going to use Ceramite White, okay? And it's mainly because of just the consistency, because what happened was when I opened this when I opened this up from Games Workshop, it was brand new. It was completely dry inside, okay? And so what I thought I'd do is I thought I'd take an advantage of that, take advantage of a bad situation and turn this into my stripe paint. So I added some water and stuff like that. And I know poor Austin was saying to me before, like, oh, I was surprised I don't use medium. Man, to be honest, I'm not gonna waste expensive medium on stuff like this. It's just some base coat stripe paint, okay? I'm just gonna use water for it, okay? Now, the consistency, I'll just give you a look at my consistency as well, right? So you can sort of see the sort of consistency I'm going at. It's not dry, but it's not completely a base coat consistency either. So it's hard to see. I just don't want to split all over the floor, but you can see how it's kind of dripping down a bit. Alright, so it's got a slight sort of wetness to it, slight drip, alright, but it's not crazily thick either, okay, so let's close that, give that a massive shake, okay, make sure you give that a massive shake as well, alright, and okay, so first thing we go through and just remove some obstacles, so I'm just going to go through, take these off, these weapons off, just put them aside. And that way, we're not going to get, obviously, white onto those weapons either, okay? Where we don't want it, all right? And just keep shaking that paint. And now I'm going to use this Tamiya tape. You can use any sticky tape, to be honest, any masking tape. But just be warm. Electrical tape's a little bit better, okay? As long as the model is varnished. Don't use gaff or something crazy like that. Just, you want the sticky tape to be, adhesive enough to stick on the model. But you don't want to go too nuts with it. That's going to rip your paint off, okay? So you can see, this is Tamiya modeling tape. It comes in a variety of sizes. All right, this is the thicker one, which I'm using because it's basically, it's a thick area, okay? So the first thing I need to do is this a little bit tatted up here. The first thing that I need to do is make sure when I tear this off that the tape is straight, okay? We want the tape to be straight on those edges, right, just here, so that means when we spray inside, once again, our stripe will be a lot neater, but also what it means is we're going to get less seep through, okay? So I'm just going to just move this tank, whoa, not destroy my tank, move this tank a little bit forward, okay? And now I'm just going to go through and put this sticky tape on the model. Okay, so I'll probably just bring it more to the edge. Alright, there we go. Just try to get as best of the camera as I can. So first stripe, we'll look at it. I'll probably put the first stripe just down here. Right, and then the next stripe will probably just go here. Right, so I'll probably just come around. I mean, I could have it going through the door even, make it a little bit thinner on this one. Maybe I will. Usually I make my stripes pretty thick, but I'm probably just going to make it thinner in this instance, just so it looks a bit better. So, yeah. Now, the other good thing about this Tamiya tape is, too, you can see through it a little bit. So I can actually use it to, align it to make sure I get a straight line. So I can actually use that door as a bit of a straight edge. So now let's push it a little bit that way. And that's reasonably straight. I'll just run my finger across it like that. Now, we want that edge, particularly here, to be as airtight or as tight to the model as we can. All right, so that way, the more this is gonna adhere to the surface of the model, all right, the less slippage we're gonna get, okay? And now it's just a matter of going through and just doing the other side. So I'm gonna pre-tear my sticky tape off. All right, I'll use the edge, which is the best. It doesn't matter if we get a little bit of tearing here and there, because I'm gonna come back and weather this off anyway. I'm just gonna come in here and I'm just gonna put that one on here like that. And I mean, you could see it's fairly straight. It's fairly straight. It doesn't have to be exact, but I mean, look, it's gonna come out a heck load neater, all right, than it will by hand, right? If you were to paint this by brush by hand. In addition, it's super important too, because, so you can see here, see that little gap there? Okay, we're gonna get slippage there. right? So we're going to try to close that off. But we can always come back and sort of like, you know, weather it off a little bit later anyway, okay? And strip it back. But the more work we do now, the easier it's going to be for us later, okay? Now, the other thing we need to do is we need to come in and we need to mask off this bottom section. This is super important, okay? Because otherwise it's going to come here and destroy the work that we've done on our wheels. So what I'm going to do in this instance, I'm going to come in, I'm going to probably just feather off just around about here, just on the edge, right? Now, I'm doing it just on the edge because I don't want it to sort of bleed through, all right? And what I'll do is I'll just come back in with a brush after I've done this work to basically fix up the, you know, any seepage that I might have, okay? I'm going to get a little piece now, and I'm going to come in and just stick it over there like that. Once again, I can come in and just paint over that with a brush later. Nobody is going to notice. All right. I mean, we'll probably notice now because I've pointed it out. but generally, no one's going to notice. And let's not forget up the top as well. Okay. So in this instance, I'm just going to come in. I'm just going to, once again, just tie a little bit from the top. Because most of these top sections, they're going to get weathered anyway, right? They're going to get like rust, or they're going to get, you know, sort of like chipping and stuff applied to it. So, yeah, better to just have it fall short. That's a little bit too much. So this is a cool thing about Tamiya tape as well. You can just get it off really. I think it's right about here. All right, fantastic. So we got on that there. And that's pretty much to do it. Now, what I'm going to do off camera, I'm just going to go through, just tape out a few more areas when I want to add the racing stripes, okay? And then I'll come back and I'll show you the next step, okay? Fantastic. So what I've done, everybody, I've gone through and I've masked off the areas of the model that I want to paint. So I've obviously done that side. You see me do that, okay? And over here, I've now done that side as well. And I've done a top as well. So let me just move the camera up over here. And you can see the top, this little top part, okay? Now this top part, I think, is probably going to give us the most grief. Because that is, there's this little groove down there that you could probably see. And we're going to get paint seeping down through there. But look, I could have gone crazy and basically, you know, filled it with glue tack or something. But I figure it should be okay because it's going to be shadows in there anyway. And, you know, like, I'll probably have to fix it anyway. So, yeah. Now, another tip I'm going to give you, it's falling off right now. I've got to sort of fix this up a little bit more because I couldn't have been bothered getting the other tape. I'm just using this tape. It's probably not the best thing to do considering, like, it is expensive. But the other thing, and this is probably the biggest tip I could give you, everybody, in this video, is to cover the rest of the model, okay? This is a massive thing that I found, had to find out the hard way, okay? I actually found it out when I started doing the Fire Raptor, and I haven't done it since because I've learned from it since then. But what you should do, you should have some kind of mobile, you know, sort of cover system available to you, so you could go through and shield different parts of the model as you're working, right? Okay. And you should also just go through and chuck up, like, you know, a little bit of a shield around your model. So what happened was, when I was doing my Fire Raptor, and then I think I did the Sakaran Venator afterwards, and I noticed certain parts of the armor were just looking a lot lighter. I'm like, hang on, what's going on here? And then all of a sudden, I noticed it was, even though I was being very careful spraying here, what was happening, the bounce off the spray was then ricocheting off onto other parts of the model. And, you know, that's pretty devastating, because especially on metallic schemes and stuff like that, you know, because it was, you know, because if it was like just like ultramarine blue or something, it probably wouldn't matter so much. You could just sort of go over it. But, you know, with this kind of scheme, whereas there's a, you know, it's like a 30-step process, it stuffs up pretty bad, right? So that's a massive tip there that I wanted to give you guys, all right? So what we're going to do for now, we're going to go through, we're going to start spraying. So I've got my white in a cup here, okay? And I've just tested the consistency on the wall, all right? You can do it wherever you want, really. All right, now what we want to do It's really up to you how you go about this. A lot of people like to do it strong and fast, so it doesn't stick, sort of seep through the sides of the sticky tape. But I actually like to do it slow and just build the paint up over time. Okay, so I'm just going to move the camera a little bit here. So I'm actually spraying this pretty much dead front on. Okay, and because I want to avoid the paint going through these seams. All right, so what I'll do, I'm going to start in the middle here. All right, just test my flow. All right, cool. And now from there, I'm just going to come in. Remember, I'm coming in front on. And I'm just going to do very, very slow maneuvers. Now, this is obviously Games Workshop paint, so, you know, it's going to be very troublesome to work with. Sorry, it's just the truth. But we just want to come up here and just very slowly start to build a little bit of a base. There we go. There it comes. All right. You can see here, just slowly building it up. And now I'm going to start working my way across. Just doing little cross hatches like that. Okay. And there we go. All right. Now it is coming up a little bit splotchy, but that's fine because I'm going to put this on pretty thick, so it's going to cover over it, okay? We don't worry about this thin the paint's rubbish when we're doing this, okay? Now, what I should be using, you can even see here, it's starting to pop up a little bit over there, but because I'm doing it on camera, I forgot, because I was concentrating on doing that and compensating for Games Workshop's crappy paint consistencies. I'll just move the camera as well over this way. But not a big deal there, that can be fixed, probably going to be weathered either. I'll put the shield over like this, right, and just go back again. Alright, so here we are, coming in, straight on, nice and thick. Alright, now stop it right there, okay, and we'll just let that dry for maybe like 60 seconds. We don't have to go crazy with it, okay, but just let it dry for about 60 seconds, because what we'll do, see, if we don't let it dry, what's gonna happen is the paint is just gonna pull up, it's gonna get very thick, and you're gonna get these areas which are gonna blotch on, okay? You can also use a hairdryer too to increase the time of that. A lot of my subscribers know I like to use a hairdryer. But I haven't plugged it in at the moment, so that's okay. Usually I'll do that. Just give it a bit of a... Actually, we don't want to blow on it because we'll mess it up. But just in here and just keep it going, so... All right, there we go. Now, yes, the paint is a little bit thick. And I know a lot of people sort of have a crack at me for that. But I find that when the paint is a little bit thicker, it's very unlikely, it's less likely that it's going to seep through these edges, as long as we're spraying it front on. Okay. And I think that should do it. Just make sure I get this side part here. Yeah, make sure you get a nice even consistency, all right? Cool. And you can actually see, like, how the, you know, we're probably still going to get some actually, but that would have helped to minimize it. But you can actually see how the paint sort of spreads around. So what we're going to do, we do not want to remove the sticky tape straight away, okay? We want to let the paint dry for a little while, just basically so that when we remove the sticky tape, it doesn't tear the paint off and smudge it all around. We can fix that later, okay? But like I said before, the less work we need to do to clean it up, the better, okay? So what I'm going to do, I'm gonna go through, do the rest of it off camera. It's same technique all around, okay? And then what I'll do is I'll come back and we'll have a look at it and we'll start doing the final touches, like the chipping and the weathering and things like that. All right, fantastic, everybody. I've just removed some of the sticky tape, and you can see here, if you have a look here on the edge, you can see how I have this white residue here. All right, from the spraying, and also this part here. All right, you can see there's like little bits of white speckle on there. Now that's not a massive deal because I could just quickly come over and paint that over black again. But I just wanted to illustrate that example. And if I didn't put the shield up, it would be a lot worse. Okay, so I'm going to go through. I'm just going to... Should be safe to pull this away. You see here now, I've taken that away. There's not much damage over here. That was there before, okay? That sort of speckling. That was from when I was doing the tracks. But yeah, fantastic. So it should be safe to remove this now. Alright, so I'm just going to put the camera down for a second, guys, because this is very, very delicate. Okay, but yeah, we managed to not get much of it here. Alright, which is fine. Okay, so... And I just want to go through, just slowly just peel it off like that, okay? And there we go. So for the most part, it's pretty decent. We do have a little bit of bleed over here, okay? But that's not a massive deal. We're going to fix that up. Alright, so just make sure you pull it off straight and all the way down. Alright, cool. So yeah, it's not bad. Like I said, we will get a little bit of bleeding, but we could fix that up, okay? Now, it probably would have been better if I come up a little bit higher here, but with that said, like, you know, most of that is gonna be done chipped around there anyway, so I'll just get some white paint, sort of clean that up a little bit, okay? So I'll show you the cleanup as well once I've finished the other side, okay? Yeah, this one here is going to be, at the top, is going to be a real pain in the ass, that's for sure. All right, so let's go ahead, let's do this side now. I don't really think you need to see me do this because I've already done the exact same thing. I'm going to try to keep some of the white a little bit better away from this area, okay? Yeah, the darker your colors are, the more this is going to show up too. All right, guys, fantastic. So all I'm doing now, I'm just coming in and just basically just fixing up these little top sections a little bit. I am working with white, so it can be a little bit harder to do. But just remember, guys, always work with multiple thin coats of white. Whenever you're working with white, if you want it to be smooth, work with a clean, sharp brush, okay? And the rest of it's not a problem. And just be very careful here that you don't mess up the straight lines that you've worked so hard to do, okay? So basically, that's very important there as well. But overall, it's pretty decent. We can come back in and chip things up a little bit more later. Over here, this is going to be a bit of an issue, but I could just cover that with a little bit blue paint. That's not a massive deal there. Once again, weathering will cover that, okay? So whatever you can't get rid of, cover it with weathering. That's basically the trick. Now, I was really surprised too. There's the other side done, okay? It's nice and straight, pretty straight. That top bit's still drying there, okay? I was surprised about this this top part here. It came out really, really well. Okay, so yeah, it's just a matter of touch and go, everybody. All right, so fantastic. Now, we can come in, if you wanna add a little bit of variation on the sides, what you can do, you actually can get a little bit of terps or water and just basically come in here and add these streaks across the side, sort of make this a little bit more jittery and stuff, okay? But I've decided I'm probably not going to do that on this tank. I do like the lines pretty clean, I know, and if it is going to be like torn up, what I'll probably do is I'll probably do that in the weathering stage anyway to get that variation in there, you know? Yeah, so fantastic. Well, anyway, everybody, look, I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. I've definitely enjoyed making it. If you like the tutorial and you're not a subscriber, please consider subscribing to the channel. We do tutorials like this very often. Also, we cover heaps of news on Warhammer and stuff like that as well. And yeah, fantastic. Give the video a like if you're around. The next one, like I said, we're going to be doing a Space Wolf one soon. And the next one I'm probably going to do as well, I'm probably going to be doing a tutorial on weapon burn. Alright, show you how I do my weapon burn as well, so that should be pretty cool. Yeah, fantastic. Alright, everybody, I'll see you in the next video. Steve, Command Centre Wargaming.